everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I have an exciting video for you. I'm going to be talking again about alternative communications. Communications that you could use during a disaster or an emergency or just any other time that you want to with ham radios. Have a new one to unbox and show you. And I want to talk to you about what I had shared earlier about the particular TID radio that I had because I sent it back and for a good reason. Hang on. Okay, here we are. I have a new Baofeng UV82. Yeah, UV82 high power they call it. But actually, I believe it's only a 5 watt. But it's a dual band radio. Comes with a guide, just like any of the rest of them. Comes with a little antenna. And since we're on antennas, I want to talk about antennas. I have these out for you. This is the little rubber ducky antenna. Most Baofengs typically come with that. Some have been, I have a few other ones, and they've been coming with this antenna lately. And I want you to see it here on against the white background. This antenna is probably the least quality antenna of all of them. This one, that's a little more slender as it gets to the top and has a little cap on it, this one I have on a UV5R3, which is a tri-band. And I was up at Dogwood Trace, and by mileage, the way the crow flies, it's probably between 50 and 55 miles away from the Jonesboro repeater that is on Bono Hill. And I was literally able to get transmissions from it yesterday. I'm not sure that I was able to open the repeater, but I was at least able to hear it. I'm interested in going back up with a Nagoya 771 and seeing what will happen, but I wanted to let you know that when you take your ham license, they'll tell you that these antennas are not very good. This one at least is a little bit better, but I'm not going to use this one with this 82. I have an NA771 Nagoya that I purchased for it. You see that it's a little longer. These will improve your reception and your transmission. There's times when I have used my tri-band radio and I couldn't even open the repeater at Truman, which is about less than 20 miles, let's say. But I was able to communicate with this antenna. And so, antenna basics. Now, here's a Nagoya 701. And it's kind of like the other one here, but notice the difference. It's not that much longer than your typical rubber ducky antenna. But it is a better antenna than these. And so, in this situation, you know the old phrase of you get what you pay for? Well, that's very true. These come with the radio. They're not very good. These little antennas like this are pretty good. But this antenna on my tri-band will not open the repeaters at Harrisburg and Truman about 20 miles away. This antenna will, and I'm able to communicate. So I'm interested in seeing how with this 82 it will communicate as well. So I'm going to set these aside now. And by the way, I have two more that I purchased. I bought three for around $30, if I'm not mistaken, on Amazon. So you can get them from $20, $21 individually to considerably less when you buy them in quantity. And I have four of these radios, one for each vehicle and one for each home, Dogwood Trace up there and one for here so that we can communicate. And so, user manual is important. The user manual, you should read and familiarize yourself with all of them. However, you're going to end up programming this radio with Chirp. And so you're going to need your Baofeng programming cable and you're going to use your computer. But just wanted to show you, I've already taken it out and put the belt clip on the back because you have to take a screwdriver and do that, but they don't come attached, but they're easily attachable. And so it's a nice radio. It cost me $35, I believe. Don't quote me on that, but I will put a link below in the description of the video, and I will link where I got it off of Amazon. But you just slide the battery on. Let's see if I can slide it on. Now that I have the belt clip, there we go. Started saying, now that I have the belt clip on, it doesn't want to slide on. Antenna screws right in here. It's an SMA female. And you say, how can you tell it's female? Because right in there is a female slot, and right in there is a male stud. And so that's how you can tell. And don't make the mistake of just ordering any antenna without checking what your radio, how it's designed, because you will need one that'll fit your radio. Put it on there good and tight. If you, and then I don't mean strip it out, but I mean just hand tighten it so that it works good, or you will not get good transmissibility. How do you like that word? have a charger, you know, the simple cube that goes on the wall, plugs into your charging cradle right here, and that's standard with all of them. And with this one, we're getting a hands-free talking ear plug that has push buttons on it. Nothing in the bottom of the box. Let's turn it on and see if it'll come on.
Channel mode.
Well, it does, and you heard that say channel mode. And there you go. And so let's see if I can switch it. Nope, and it doesn't have an A and B button on it, so I can't switch it from channel, from frequency mode to channel mode, at least right here on a button that I can see. But it has two push to talk buttons, and it also has an FM radio button, and it's on 65.0, so there's no channel in my area for that. But you do need to program these with your cable and Chirp. And I'm going to pause for a moment and go get my cable. And I'm going to program it. And I'll come back and I'll show you something. But show you something very interesting. I'll show you how that I can literally open a repeater in the area. And I'll tell you exactly how far that repeater is away, which is good for alternative communication. Now, before I do that, I want to share with you, why did I get this particular radio? Just not many days ago, I did a video and I showed you a TID radio, a TD-6B that I got, which was a nice little radio. It was the same thing as a UV-9S, except for this. This one problem, you know, and I've talked to you about this and shared that the longer the antenna, the better for a handheld, and these Nagoya 771s are very good antennas. That UV9S variant, which was TID Radio's TD-6B, would not take a Nagoya 771 or a Super Slinky or any other aftermarket antenna, because right here, this round sleeve area around the antenna was small. I was not able to get it to work. I even took my 701 Nagoya, and I took it out in the shop, and I took my hand grinder and ground all of this down and touched it up and made this narrower so that it would screw in there, and I couldn't get it to screw in far enough to literally for the stud in here and the receptor to mate and make a good connection and be able to transmit with it. The only thing that I could transmit with was the little antenna that, and it was literally one of these little rubber ducky antennas. This one was the only one I was able to get to go in far enough that was small enough, had a small enough shoulder to work on that radio. I wrote an email to TID Radio, contacted them, and said, I have this particular model. I want to put a Nagoya 771 aftermarket antenna on there. You make a TD-771 knockoff of this Nagoya. Will it work on your radio? And they said no. They just suggested that I use the rubber ducky antenna with it that came with it, and that's all. Well, that's not, you know, that doesn't work for me. That's a no-go. And so I boxed it up. It was less than 30 days. Amazon has a 30-day return policy. That's one of the great things about them. If you buy something that comes shipped from Amazon, by the way, make sure you, if you're buying something from them, you want to be able to return it no hassle. Make sure it ships from Amazon. I boxed it back up, printed out a return label, no problem, no muss, no fuss. Took it to my local Kohl's, dropped it off at the Amazon return counter, walked out. As soon as I got to the car, it hit my cell phone that they had given me my refund. And so that's why I bought this particular radio. I have a UV5R 8 watt that is a great radio. And I have two of the UV5R 3s, which are tri-bands. And I'm going to try and learn how to use the tri-bands. I'm not sure how to do that yet. But I wanted to go ahead and buy the 82 because it's a little more rugged radio. And so that's why I sent the TID radio back. Was it a bad radio? No. Worked good. Had a little more than 7 watts whenever I measured the wattage of the radio like it's supposed to. Supposed to have more than 5 watts. But that's just a game stopper for me when it would not take an aftermarket better antenna, which would help me send and receive better. And my whole goal here is to be able to communicate to home here up to my place at Dogwood Trace in the Ozarks, which is 50-55 miles, by the way the crow flies. And let me give you a disclaimer here. We happen to have one of those places we were fortunate to buy on the top of a mountain. And so these things work, particularly communications like this work by line of sight. And so when I'm up on the top of my mountain and I have a deer stand up there and I can climb 12 feet up there, when I climb up on that deer stand on the top of my mountain, which is the highest point around that part of the world, I can literally see to the horizon, and I can see almost to Jonesboro. Not quite, you know, because the curvature of the earth, you can only see about 12 miles. But my point is, at that height, at 800 odd, 805, 810, 13, somewhere in there, feet above sea level, and looking down, I get a great transmission. And I was surprised yesterday when I received transmission with just that little factory rubber ducky antenna to the repeater here in Jonesboro. And so my goal is to put this together. Let's see if I can open the repeater. I was able to open the repeater at M. Bowden from where I was. And I was able to open one of the Jonesboro repeaters from where I was with the little rubber ducky antenna. And so with this, I'm interested in seeing how I can communicate. All right, let me get my cable. Let me get this thing programmed. I'll come back to you in a moment or two. Okay, I've gotten that programmed and I'm back. I do want to show you. It takes a programming cable like this, and I bought this off of Amazon as well. It says Baofeng on it. It has a chip in here, actually, and you get a little CD with it, or you can download the current driver. And you need the current driver to work with your particular PC, whether it's Windows, Mac, or Windows 10. And mine, and this says it has a Baofeng CH340 in there. And I got it from Abree, A-B-B-R-E-E. And I got one or two of my radios from them. But you need that, and Chirp is free, it's easy, and if you're any kind of a computer literate person, most of you are, I know, it'll work for you. All right, let's turn this thing on. As you can see, the display came on. Turn it up here louder. I have it on Jonesboro for the Jonesboro repeater, I'm in my home. It's the Bono Hill, so it's probably 15 miles away. Let's see if I can hit that repeater. Repeater check. There you go. Let me switch it to Harrisburg, which is probably 15 miles south of me this way. My repeater check. There you go. So in the house, I can hit a couple of repeaters. I have tried since I went away and programmed it. I did try Cherokee Village, which I could hit at Dogwood Trace. I can't hit it from here. I could hit Emboden. I can't hit it from here. And I could also hit Highland, and I can't hit it from here. Oddly enough, I was closer to Thayer, and they have a repeater up there, and I couldn't hit it from my place, and I know I'm high enough. And so it must be a low power repeater, and so I'm interested in taking it. But this UV82 high power is the one that I'm going to take up to Dogwood Trace and leave it there to be able to communicate. And so I hope that this information and all of this that I'm sharing with you is helpful. I intend to set myself up a dipole antenna, a long wire antenna, and let's see if I can't communicate from here to there by handheld, and that'll be in another video in the future. So if you have questions or comments, please leave them below. We really appreciate you taking the time to visit our channel. Please help us feed the YouTube algorithm by leaving a comment. Please do. Hit the like button, subscribe, share with a friend. God bless you. Have a super day.